What's up, guys? Happy Wednesday. Thanks for tuning in with us. Before we get into live and everything that's happening, I just got to address something. So if you weren't already confused enough about who's who, I get called Erica all the time. She gets called Erin. It's fine. We respond to either name. But we showed up to work today in the exact same outfit, pretty much. So this tan shirt, black holy jeans, and cheetah shoes to top it all off. Cheetah girls, it's awesome. So besides that, we have a great night planned for you. We're super excited about our new set, but some things have been happening around the office. You know, quarantine life, things are a little different. It's bringing out some things and some people. What's been happening?
Yeah, so we've been introduced to someone named Quarantine Evan.
Yeah.
You just never know what he's going to show up wearing, what kind of shoes he's going to have on, what he's going to smell like. We just don't really
His
know.
His facial hair. You just never know.
I'm trying to grow a beard right now. You might have seen that yesterday. So it's always interesting. And then with Seth, he bleached his hair again. He wanted to be platinum.
Yep.
And this time, you know, we did it at home. So it took about 7 to 10 times.
Not recommended. Don't try that at home.
Don't ever try that much at home. And now you just don't know what color is going to be in his hair. Is he going to add silver tips to it, pink tips to it? So
Blue.
Yeah, it's just, it's been super interesting. We've also been doing yoga together in the office. We have a big open space now. And so that's been super interesting. It's like a kid's yoga.
Frozen edition.
Frozen theme. So, yeah, all kinds of interesting things happening.
Fun stuff. Well, have you seen these TikToks? Okay, so people will say, most likely to do this, most likely to do that. Okay, so we thought that it would be fun to do an office edition. We can't get everyone up here now, but we have some questions that I think will be interesting for you all to learn. So I'm gonna read some questions, and then we'll say who we think is the most likely, okay?
Like at the same time to see if we
the same match. Person.
Okay,
first one, most likely to shave head.
Seth,
I was gonna say that. Most likely to have more than 5 kids.
Evan.
Yeah. Most likely to give all their money to charity. I honestly have no idea.
You ready? 1, 2, 3.
Olivia? It is Lisa. Okay, number 4. Most likely to catch feelings or get emotional.
One, two, three.
Me? Yeah, you. I was going to say you, but I thought you would get mad.
No, I don't.
Okay.
It's true.
Number 5, most likely to jump out of an airplane. I can't think of one. Okay. I got it. Ready? 3, 2, 3. Seth.
Nathan.
Oh, Nathan, maybe. Yeah, we hope that gives you some insight on our staff, the crazy things that we do. But we got a great night planned. It's going to be awesome.
So excited. Jump into worship with us. And then we are going to have some of our seniors up here sharing their stories with you guys.
I saw Satan fall like lightning. I saw darkness run for cover. But the miracle that I just can't get over, my name is registered in heaven. I believe in signs and wonders. I have resurrection power. Still the miracle that I just can't get over, my name is registered in heaven. Oh, my praise belongs to you forever. This is my testimony from death to life. His grace rewrote my story. I'll testify by Jesus Christ the righteous. I'm justified. This is my testimony. This is my testimony. Sons and daughters, bought with blood and washed in water. Sing the praises of the Spirit, Son and Father. I, God, will finish what He started. Oh, my God, will finish what He started. This is my testimony from death to life. 'Cause grace rewrote my story. I'll testify by Jesus Christ the righteous. I'm justified. This is my testimony. This is my testimony. Oh. You're not done. Greater things are still to come. If I'm not dead, you're not done. Greater things are still to come. Oh, I believe. If I'm not dead, you're not dead. Grace rewrote my story. I'll testify by Jesus Christ the righteous. I'm justified. This is my testimony. This is my testimony from death to life. 'Cause grace rewrote my story. I'll testify by Jesus Christ the righteous. I'm justified. This is my testimony. Oh, 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 how high would I climb mountains if the mountains were where you hide? Oh, how far would I scale valleys if you grace the other side? Oh, how long have I chased rivers from lowly seas to where they rise against the rush of grace descending from the source of its supply? 'Cause in the highlands and the heartache, you need them more or less inclined. I would search and stop at nothing. You're just not that hard to find. I will praise you on the mountain. I will praise you in the mountains in my way. You're the summit where my feet are. I will praise you in the valleys all the same. No less God within the shadows, no less faithful when the night leads me astray. You're the heaven where my heart is. In the highlands, in the heartache, all the same. Oh, how far beneath your glory does your kindness extend the path from where your feet rest on the sunrise to where you sweep the sinners past? And oh, how fast would you come running if just a shadow? like a lamb was slain for me. I will praise you on the mountain. I will praise you in the mountains in my way. You're the summit where my feet are. I will praise you in the valleys all the same. Nor the scarred within the shadow.
Erica and Aaron said, thank you so much for joining us tonight. We're so glad that you chose to be a part of Live Online. Whether you're watching on YouTube or Instagram, we are glad that you're here. And tonight is a special night because tonight is all about senior stories. I have some special guests with me. These are some of our students, some of our seniors who are about to graduate and go to college. That's amazing. And before they do a couple of things tonight, number one, they want to share with you their background, their story, what God has done in their life. And also they want to share what he's taught them. And so I'm so excited for that, but I want to introduce them so that you know who's talking to you tonight. First, this is Miranda Smith. She is so amazing. I've known Miranda for a long time. Miranda goes to Cinco Ranch High School. Excited for her to share tonight. This is Jayden Collymore. Jayden also goes to Cinco Ranch High School. He's been going to this church for a very long time. Thanks for being here, buddy. And then this is Ashtyn Ernstes. Ashtyn goes to Mayde Creek High School. Go Rams, Ashtyn. Thank you so much for being here. Excited for you to hear from them. And so tonight, we're going to start ladies first with Miranda Smith. Miranda, tell us your story.
So I grew up at Second Baptist. My family's gone here for ages, and my sisters are super involved. Going into junior high, I was the most annoying church Jesus kid. I wanted everybody to go to Fall Riot with me. I wanted all of my friends in my beach retreat condo. And I was just that girl. That's what I was known as. And I wanted everybody to just be as happy as I was because of how much I loved the Lord. Then going into high school, I made a new group of friends, and they were very discouraging about my faith. And eventually it just grew to me becoming silent about it, and I no longer was excited about coming to church. I wasn't excited about bringing new people with me. I just kind of became very stagnant in my relationship. I was coming to church and still kind of involved, but more to just check a box rather than because I actually wanted to, and it was something that I wanted to do. During the time of me being stagnant, I lost my aunt because of cancer, and that left me rock bottom. I was in a very dark place for a long time, and my parents were awesome, but they had to step back and take care of the rest of my family. My sisters are much older than me, so they had just moved out, and I was just left in a place of feeling alone. And I didn't know who I was. I didn't have my identity anywhere. I was just lost for a while. And then my junior year of high school, I decided that I was going to figure out who God was to me. And I was going to take ownership of my faith and to stop relying on the people around me that were going to church or my parents taking me to church. That was going to be something I decided to do. And so I started reading my Bible and listening to sermons online and just really figuring out what I believed and who God said that I was and who God is to me. And I believe that that's where my walk with God just took a turn, and it really took off from there. From that moment of change, I have seen all of the people that God has placed in my life and their intention there and why God placed them in my life when he placed them in my life. Those people have brought me out of where I was and brought me to where I am today.
Yeah, and my story is similar to Miranda's
in the sense that God's placed a lot of key people in my life, and they've truly helped shape who I am today. One of them is my grandmother. She's the most amazing woman I know.
That's awesome. Because in fifth grade, unfortunately, my father went to prison and was looking at a lot of time, which...
A lot of stress on my mom.
And unfortunately, she fell in a pit
of drugs
and wasn't able to be a parent to me and my five sisters. So
my grandma took me and my five sisters in, which is super crazy to me because at the time she was already raising three of my other cousins. So at one point she was hauling nine kids to church two times a week.
Wow.
Yeah, that's crazy to me. I wouldn't be able to do that. And yeah, I
just immediately fell in love with the environment of church because I'm a super open person. I didn't have trouble making friends or anything. So yeah, I just loved coming to church. And church changed me a lot for the better. Just hearing everyone else's stories and sharing mine has been amazing. After like 8 or 9 years not talking to my father, this past Christmas, I was feeling a lot of sympathy for him. I felt bad for him. And
God let me,
or helped me build up the courage to write him a letter. And it took a couple of months to actually send it. But yeah.
Well, my story is very similar to Ashton's, you know.
When I was younger, my parents were together. You know, my mom was working as a single parent. My dad was in my life as much as I wish he was. And, you know, that led to my grandma having to raise me. At the time, she was very highly on medications and dealing with the passiprone that caused her to be with a medication. You know, and oftentimes she would overdose on that. And, you know, I ended up having to take care of myself some nights, or a lot of nights, per se. And leading up into middle school, I moved here from Haley to Katie. I became someone I wasn't proud of. You know, I was arrogant, cocky, rude, you know, you name it. You know, but leading up to my freshman year, I found myself hanging with the wrong group of people. You know, they're heavy on drugs, heavy on alcohol, you know. Luckily for me, I didn't get addicted to those drugs. You know, I still was smoking weed, drinking. And that really caused me to become depressed. You know, alcohol is a depressant and weed's a pollution. So that really took a toll on my mind mentally and physically. You know, I was filled with depression, anxiety. You know, suicidal thoughts were right around the corner. And it really shattered my faith because as I was living the life that I did not want to be, I often found myself, you know, just depressed, sad. I remember I cried a lot of nights because I was, you know, I'm going to say it again, I was depressed. And leading up to that, I said, look, Gabe, you need to change. And even though God might not be there in your eyes, at some point he will reveal himself. And leading into junior year, I was still, you know, hanging with that group of people. I kind of eased off on it, on what they were doing. And I said, I need to find people in my life that I can be proud of, to call my friends and to be a role model. Because, and then sometimes, you know, when I would look and see them doing some certain things, I'm going to backtrack a little bit. It really traumatized me because I just, but I found those group of friends that really stood out to me. I wanted to be like them. I used to watch role models. And leading up, I was thinking about quitting basketball. You know, I didn't want to play anymore. And that was I don't know, looking back, if I did that, I don't know, I'd be so mad at myself, because now I'm finding myself and finding who I'm meant to be, because God is finally showing the path that I feel like I'm supposed to walk. You know, I'm playing college basketball. I found people that I can trust, I can be close to. I found people I can look up to, be role models. And, you know, just my senior year, I really found myself. I'm still finding myself. And, you know, the future is always something to look forward to.
It was really a challenge, very difficult for these students to be real with you tonight. What they have walked through in their lives is not easy. It's very difficult. I mean, you should feel the emotion just in this room where we are right now in this space, because it's so real what they've gone through, the things that life has thrown at them, but the amazing ways that God has worked and the ways that God has pulled them out of where they are. And so that's why right now they can share with you what they want to share about the things God has done and what he has taught them and what they want you to know about that. And so we're going to spend the last few minutes of them just sharing what God has put on their heart. And I want to start with Ashtyn.
Yeah, to anyone out there who is in a pit and can't get out, fighting struggles, I just want to let you know that it does get better. I know it's kind of corny, but it gets better. And I'm not saying it's going to be like a light switch, like you just flip it and you have a perfect life, but it definitely gets better. I found a verse, Isaiah 41:10, and it says, "So do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand," which to me says basically that God's got this. Mm. He's got you.
And for my Bible verse, you know, it really saved me when I found it, and you know, I have it all over my room, and it's on my letterman and whatnot. So good. It's 2 Corinthians 12:9-10, and it says, "But he said to me, my grace is sufficient for you, my power is made perfect in weakness. Therefore I will boast all the more gladly about my weakness, so that Christ's power may rest on me. That is why for Christ's sake I delight in weakness and insults and hardships and persecutions and difficulties. But when I am weak, then I am strong." Mm. And when I found that, it really struck home with me, because, you know, I've seen rock bottom. I've been to my highest peak in high school.
Hopefully not the highest peak, but you know, I've been there, and it's just feeling lonely and depressed and anxious. Everything you can ever think of, I've been there. And there's always something to look forward to, because with resilience comes trial and error, but at the same time it comes pushing through hardships and fighting for what you want and what you believe in. And that's what God taught me looking back, because I could have gave up so many times, and truthfully speaking, I cannot be here talking to you and being with these fine people at the moment, because it was
very tough at some moments in my life. But I fought through it. And looking towards the future, I hope someone I can be proud of.
I'm trying to be better for my future, for my wife and my kids when I get them, and for people around me when I'm older. And that's something that God taught me to be. And I couldn't be more proud of my life, because it's something that I can be proud of when I'm older.
Awesome.
All right. I want to encourage everybody watching this video, whether you are coming into high school as a freshman or you're leaving for college, to really make your faith your own, and to take ownership of it, and to stop coming to church just to check off a box, to do it because that's what you want to do and that's who God is to you, that you want to know more about him. And I found this verse, 1 Corinthians 2:4-5, that says, "And my message and my preaching were not in persuasive words of wisdom, but in demonstration of spirit and of power, so that your faith would not rest on the wisdom of men, but on the power of God." And that second part in verse 5, just that your faith would not rest on the wisdom of men and on the power of God, means so much to me, because in my life I found times where I was relying on the people around me to come to church, or for my parents to bring me to church. And it wasn't until that moment where I had this desire to know who God was that was when my relationship really took off and I was able to make something of it.
Yeah, make your faith your own. That's amazing. I hope that wherever you are watching this, your bedroom, your living room, your kitchen, I don't know where it is, but I hope that you're applauding these students for an amazing job and for being real, as I said. That's not an easy thing to do. The verse that comes to my mind as we close is a verse from Genesis, I think it's 50, verse 20. And it's a moment where Joseph is talking to the same brothers who once sold him into slavery, who wanted to ultimately kill him. But one of the brothers decided, hey, let's just sell him into slavery because that might be too bad to kill him. And so let's do this instead, but it'll still be punishment enough for Joseph. And now Joseph later on in Genesis is now facing those same brothers. He's in front of them, and God has elevated Joseph to a place where he has authority, where he has been blessed, where he is seeing God work in his life. And he speaks to those same brothers who threw him in the pit, who sold him into slavery. And he says to them, what you intended to harm me, God intended for my good. I'm going to say that again. What you intended to harm me, God used and intended for my good. And I want you to know, wherever you are, if you are in a place like these students have been in, and we are in many times in our life, because life is hard. Life is a struggle. Life is full of sin. It's full of trials. It's full of pain. It's full of suffering. I want you to know that whatever's coming against you, may it be the enemy, may it be the world, that God is for you. And God is going to take that just like he did in their lives and in my life. And he's going to turn it for your good. Maybe you're already seeing that right now in your life. Maybe you haven't seen that yet. You're waiting for it like Jayden was. I want you to know, as Ashtyn said, it gets better. God's got the future. He's in control. He has the final word. So in a minute, I want to pray for you. I also want to encourage you. We sang a song at the beginning of this called My Testimony. That song says, God's put a story in my life. He's given me a background that I've been through, I've gone through. Maybe I'm still going through that. But God is working and has worked in my life. He's not finished with my story yet, but he's given me something amazing to share with everybody. And just as they have done, you can do the same thing. You can share your testimony. You can testify about what God has done in your life. What does that look like? Students, parents, adults. It means having conversations. It means stepping out of your comfort zone and stepping into what God wants you to do. So maybe there's somebody right now that God is putting on your heart that you need to share your story with. Maybe it's getting on your social media and turning it into, man, I want you to know, not in a prideful way, but what God has done in my life, so maybe he can do the same in yours. So you can be encouraged today. You can be blessed today. I want to encourage you to step into that. Embrace what God has done. Share that with somebody. So as we close right now, I want to pray for all of you watching this. Again, students, great job. Thank you for what you said today, for being real. So amazing to see what God is doing in your life. Let's close in prayer. Lord God, I thank you for everybody who's watching this, who's here right now, for these students and what you have done, how you've worked, how amazing you are. God, as you told us in Genesis, as Joseph said, he saw it in his life. God took the things that came against him and turned them and used them for Joseph's good. And you tell us that in the book of Romans, that anything the enemy puts against us, comes against us, you want to turn that and work that according to your will and to your purpose in our lives. So Father, I pray that everyone watching would know that, whether it's now or in the future, God, that you take the things that we struggle with, our deepest, darkest pits, and you turn them and use them for our good. So I pray that over these people. Lord, I pray you give us the power and the courage, the spirit you've put inside of us, the Holy Spirit, to share what you've done, to embrace it, to be proud of it, to be thankful for it, because it's you working, you moving, you doing only what you can do. So give us the courage to do that. Lord, we love you. We praise you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you guys for joining us tonight. And thank you, students, for sharing what God has been putting on your heart. We greatly appreciate it. We hope to see you this Sunday at 9:30 and 11 as our in-person church worship services have resumed. And we also hope to see you join us for Bible study Zoom groups at 4 o'clock and 5 o'clock on Sunday. 4 o'clock for high school, 5 o'clock for junior high. DM us, text us, call us for any information you want more on that.
We also have Beach Retreat HTX coming up on June 15th through 18th. We'll be releasing new information about it on our Instagram and YouTube, and a ton more exciting content. We love to see you every Wednesday night. Keep joining us, and we'll see you next week.